Hello, I'm Diana Konecki, Chairwoman of DKA Strategic Planning and Konecki Associates. Today I'd like to discuss the topic of a guide. A guide, basically, in historical terms, can be someone who helps an explorer find a new area, for example, in traveling. Two examples are in the Chicago area, basically Schaumburg, as well as in Wisconsin and Lesene. Although I thought I knew Chicago basically from taking Metro and getting off at different train stops and taxis, a friend of mine was able to show me basically more of Chicago and become more acclimated to understanding the city and people better, as opposed to thinking about a city as something foreign. It's actually was a very positive experience. The main thing is, for example, like to get to Schaumburg, before, if I wanted to get to Schaumburg, what I do is I take I-94 to downtown, Illinois Tollway, 294 out to Schaumburg, again, Illinois Tollway. And what happens is basically, I would see basically a highway view of Chicago as a city and its suburbs. A friend of mine basically showed me another way on how to get down there was basically by taking I-94. Getting off at Lake Crook Road, intersecting with Highway 53, getting off at Algonquin Road to Schaumburg is a nice casual drive, and I was able to see basically more of what the nature of the community is and the people. In addition, a friend of mine introduced me to some of his friends in the area. We had a chance to talk and share ideas, share thoughts. And this is the importance of a friend and a guide in the area, because you can't do everything and don't try to. The biggest problem many inventors and entrepreneurs have is they think they can do everything and they try to, and you'll burn yourself out, or basically you're not going to do it well. The point is don't be afraid to delegate and have trust. It is important to build trust. The second example, when I was in Lesene, a friend of mine, Annette, was very helpful in helping me in Lesene and finding out different ways to help find my way around. Again, other than just basically through Washington, knowing Lesene through Washington Avenue, West Lesene, or New West Lesene, Highway 31, and Durand Avenue. Basically, it's the same process. We did a little bit of a walking tour, and I was able to meet a few people, talk with a few people, as well as basically just take different ways that normally a tourist wouldn't take. And what happens, this helped expand my knowledge of Lesene and the people. But the main point is what happens, a guide is essential in travel as well as in business. In any local area, it's good to have someone who understands the local area. When I was at my first conference in 1992, I met a nice couple from Hudson's Bay that were on vacation, and the best advice they gave me during this was a tour when we were going through a tour of Virginia City, Nevada, was they said, the best thing you could do is find someone who's local, who understands the local culture, local laws, as to help build relationships and friendships. And what happens, their advice lane too. Sometimes people forget over the years, but that's something people sometimes rediscover. But it's good. It's important advice, and I sort of am learning that. Even with the third example, with a friend of mine, who's helped me quite a bit upon my return to Kenosha, as well as getting things to understand more of the community, and also to overcome some things that basically, some things that happened in the past and move on and forward. Although, what happened basically did cause hurt to me and my family, it is important to move on and forward, which I have. And the person I'm working with has helped quite a bit. In determining a plan, a guide will help you sort of sense the area where things are most comfortable, where things could go naturally. And that's why it's important to have a guide and also to practice delegation. Thank you.